I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass. All out of bubblegum.
Browsing around Steam, I came across Meatgrinder, an action-packed, high-octane first-person shooter created by indie developer Vampire Squid, set to release this coming April. The concept of Meatgrinder is really unique and it caught my attention right away. It's like smashing together a heavy arsenal shooter like Doom or Duke Nukem, an action movie like Mad Max with the game Clustertruck, and you get Meatgrinder. Sounds badass. Fuck! After learning what this game is all about, I was amazed that it hasn't been done before by another studio. I mean, the core gameplay sounds so fun. This prompted me to do a little more research about truck hopping FPS games, and I discovered that it's not an entirely new concept. In fact, two Proteus community maps called Truck Surfer and Truck Surfer 2 by YouTube channel RobRacer97 have shown us the concept in action. Now, I'm not sure if Meatgrinder was inspired by these Truck Surfer maps, but regardless, Vampire Squid is working with a great game concept, so I was very interested in checking it out. The intro of the game tells you that you're a character with an engine for a heart and power generators for legs. You're not told why you're a mechanical being or why there's a need to hop from truck to get to the end. That seems to be of little consequence. Like most boomer shooter-inspired games, the story is just not that deep. What is important is that you have guns to shoot, enemies to kill, and if you stop, you die. So with that info, you're thrust into a stylized post-apocalyptic landscape where Mad Max-like raiders control the highways that you, for some reason, have an interest in traversing. The demo features a few different nice backdrop landscapes, and the full release will have levels on top of planes and trains, according to some animated GIFs on the Meatgrinder Steam page. The goal of the demo is pretty simple. Jump from truck while battling waves of baddies and bosses trying to stop you. The game has a simple user interface with a health bar, a heartbeat per minute, or BPM counter, and a slow-mo mode indicator. If you stop, you die, so during gameplay you have to keep your BPM high by constantly moving and shooting. Controlling the BPM also controls your health. If the meter gets too low, it will start to drain your health, but keeping it high with constant combat will regenerate your health. Movement and combat also seem to fill up the slow-mo meter, which, in my opinion, was one of the coolest aspects of this game. To hop from truck, you have a few movement mechanics at your disposal, including an air dash mechanic and a grapple hook that seems to shoot out of your foot, which is kind of fucking cool. For weapons, you only get a few, and here's to hoping the main game will have a significantly larger arsenal, but for now, you get dual pistols, a super shotgun, and a chain gun. The weapons don't require ammo. Instead, there's a temperature system with the shotgun and minigun, and overusing them requires you to have to wait a few seconds before the guns can fire again. Nothing Spartan kicking a raider to the face can solve. Visually, the game is not going to win any art awards, but it's not ugly by any means. The bright color palette fits the comic booky vibe that this game seems to be going for, and there are enough landscapes and backdrops to keep things varied. The destruction effects are the most visually impressive aspect of the game, and the changing lighting is a nice touch. As I said at the start of this video, the gameplay concept for this game is very strong. However, after playing through the demo, I came away from it quite disappointed. A Steam demo should showcase the very best aspects of a game and serve as a promotional tool to get people excited. However, this demo left me feeling skeptical about a smooth full release, as there are some serious issues with this game rooted deeply in the core mechanics. As a fan of the general idea, I'm concerned that such a great game concept will end up as a roadkill stain on Steam's proverbial video game store highway. Two of the most important aspects of a good boomer shooter are fluid movement mechanics and hard-hitting gunplay. The movement in this game is inconsistent and awkward. Jumping is too floaty with no weight behind it, and surfaces feel like they are a mixture of slippery and rubbery, as it's far too easy to accidentally slide off of a truck when moving or when grappling. The air dash has an awkward rubber bandy feel to it, as if you're pulled back just before being flung forward. It's slight, but it's enough to become jarring on the eyes. Honestly, it may may sound extremely nitpicky, but I found myself wishing I could just press the spacebar again to air dash instead of using the default shift button. To me, that would have been more intuitive, as hitting shift feels awkward while dealing with aiming, shooting, and grappling as well. I found myself concentrating too much on the movement because of this, and in a fast-paced game, movement should be second nature, allowing the player to focus on the combat instead. For example, comparing Meatgrinder to its inspiration Clustertruck, the movement in the latter is extremely polished. The physics gave the player a consistent sense of their weight and speed, enabling the player to quickly learn their momentum. You feel like you're firmly on a surface and not in danger of slipping off. These tight mechanics allow the movement to become that second nature I was talking about. With Meatgrinder, we feel as if our piston legs are also equipped with ice skates, making navigation and combat far more challenging than they need to be. Moving between trucks should be muscle memory to players after a short time, but unfortunately in Meatgrinder, you will not just be fighting hordes of ruffians, but also against the janky physics. This is why I did not play at the hardest difficulty, because even when getting the hang of the game's mechanics, I still fell off a decent amount, and on hard mode, hitting the pavement is instant death. So I avoided hard mode to preserve my sanity. Gunplay in Meatgrinder is just okay. There is a serious lack of punchy power I want from these guns, and while the super shotgun may send an enemy ragdolling away, there is something lacking to really make me feel like I'm doing the chonky damage I want. However, the game deserves credit for the slow-mo mode. When activated, I felt like a badass ripped right out of a Matrix movie. A bigger issue with the combat is not the wet paper towel weapons, but the enemies. They tend to jump at you and then stop, and sometimes they attack, but mostly they seem to just want to hang out. This often led to me standing there to shoot them, which counters the whole stop and die concept this game is going for. Honestly, the game would be better off without the BPM meter, as it's a constant afterthought during gameplay, and you rarely face danger of dying from not moving. Either it needs to affect the gameplay more significantly, or it should just not exist. The only real threat in the game, aside from falling off the trucks constantly, is the shooting enemies with perfect hitscan aim. Granted, bullets do not do a ton of damage, but there is very little counter to being shot by them. In my opinion, the game could benefit from fewer enemies that had greater impact. Instead of 4 or 5 jumping enemies that do not do much, make it one enemy that can kill the player in 2 hits if they get on their vehicle. Instead of aimbot enemies, make gunplay more dynamic and make the shots players take matter more. If this is coupled with the BPM meter that seems to keep the player pretty healthy, there would be a much more in-depth interplay between combat and that fast movement the game is trying to deliver. And while I know I've been pretty critical of this demo already, I still have to address the bugs. The demo was pretty dang buggy, with the main issue being clipping through the geometry. And while normally geometry clipping is generally ignored, at one point I clipped right through a vehicle's interior and got stuck, forcing me to restart. So yeah, I was pretty harsh on this demo. With such a cool concept like FPS Clustertruck, there are some complex mechanics that need to be nailed to make this game feel right. There were moments where it all came together and I thought it was a blast. There's serious potential here, but considering the release is right around the corner, it may be too late at this point. If Vampire Squid doesn't make some adjustments, I think this game will end up with mixed reviews on Steam at best. But maybe it will spark an interesting niche genre, and another developer will come along and nail the concept. And I guess we'll just have to wait and see. So have you tried Meatgrinder, and if so, do you agree with my review? Let me know in the comments below. Also, I've not mentioned this before, but I actually have a link to my Discord in the video description if you're interested in hanging out. As always, thanks for watching, guys. I'm Salty Octopus, and I'll see you next time.